We had a whole thing, because I said we should end on a multiple of 9. And so we, or no, it was a multiple of 7. No, it was a multiple of 2 prime numbers.
Right, and what was the next one?
There's a 49 was the closest. Yeah. So it's, we're somewhere between 35 and 49.
Yeah, that sounds right. Hey, what's up?
Fighting these floating diamonds. We are almost to the end of this whole ordeal. How does that make you feel?
Sweaty. Just, I'm pitting out this shirt, and this shirt was already pitted out when I put it on this morning, so I am just, I'm in the pits, gross. Man. They call me Mr. Pits, even when I go to work for the, Alabama.
Alabama, huh? Alabama.
I used to live in Alabama. Did you ever live in Alabama?
I drove through Alabama when I came to visit you a couple of times.
How'd that go?
There was a huge traffic jam when I was in, what's the capital of Alabama?
Birmingham? I think.
No, that's Mississippi. Whatever the... Is it Atlanta? No, it's not.
Atlanta is the capital of Georgia. I'm pretty sure the capital of Alabama is Birmingham.
Maybe you're right. Maybe it is in Alabama.
Yeah, but what the hell
geography,
is the capital
of this city? I never took geography. I took geography all throughout elementary school.
I took geography instead.
I took theogony, where we learned about the origins of the gods.
That sounds awesome. Oh. Hello, enormous sphere.
I took theodicy, where I learned why life is shitty, and why...
Theodicy is that thing where, like, you try to explain why bad things happen, even though God is omnipresent, omnipotent, and omnibenevolent, right?
All those words, yes.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Kill the pink one first. He's
Wait,
the strongest.
We've encountered this before. This is what the end. He has the shield.
So we kill the other two so they don't heal.
Yeah. We need to neutralize him first. And then we can drop a bomb on him.
So assuming he's an acid, pour a base on him.
Yes. What if he's a buffer solution?
I had chemistry right after geography.
Let's go! This fucking move takes so long. Whatever. I'm gonna drop the hot bomb on him. Great. Goods. Bazooka. Oh. Pop him. Sigh.
That reminds me. I went to a presentation about how to do good presentations the
awesome.
Other day. You know how to, like, do, like when you're defending your thesis and things like that. And the professor that was officiating it was trying to give an example of ways to, like, warm up. And one of the ways he said is just pick up a book and speak extemporaneously on whatever the topic is without reading any of the book. So he just picked up a book from one of the guys in the front row. And it happened to be, like, a advanced physics or, chemistry or something textbook.
Yeah, some kind of hard science.
The subject was, like, conductivity through fluid semiconductors. And It was hilarious trying to hear him fumble through an explanation of you know, trying to speak extemporaneously on that topic that is so arcane that...
That's totally awesome. But he just went good? Off on... Did he, like, get the job done?
No. It was ridiculous.
But you did know? Did it get the point across, though? Like, was the concept... Did it seem to be sound?
No.
Or did it make him look like an asshole?
Well, I mean, it's like... He was kind of in an impossible situation.
Yeah.
But...
He picked the worst possible thing... Like, situation in which to do that.
Yeah, well... Go figure that someone in the physics department would sit in the front row. But
fucking physics kids. I was trying to kiss up. We've reached the cosmic vagina, so...
That's it? That's the gateway to the boss?
I don't know. I'm saying this is the cosmic vagina. That's all I'm saying.
Okay. Stick it in.
Oh, God, I was more right than I could possibly have imagined.
No, I don't think that was the vagina. I think it's the other end.
Have we entered the cosmic butt?
Yeah, now you're in the cosmic colon.
I saw a news article the other day where, like, the cops in some podunk asshat town, like, pulled this dude over. For,
Podunk Asshat, Alabama?
Yeah. Yeah, you know the place. It's just south of Two Shits, Kentucky.
Alabama's not south of Kentucky. Take your geography right.
Learn geogony, jerk. But, these cops... Oh, God. Okay, seriously, we are in a vagina. That is a cervix. We are in a vagina. There is no avoiding it. There's no talking about it. I don't want to be here anymore. Let's bounce. Just fuck it.
Wait, there's both no avoiding it and no talking about it?
Correct.
A quandary.
Yes. No quandering. Nope. This is a zero quander zone. Anyway, so these... I don't want to talk about this butt story now. We need to activate the final service.
You can't do that. You have to finish the story.
Anyway, the cops pulled this dude over for doing a rolling stop through a stop sign, and he was a dude who had a history of breaking the law vis-a-vis drugs. I don't even know if that's the right way to say that. But he had some drug charges on him before, but they didn't find any drugs on him at the time. But they noticed that when they hauled him out of the car, he was, quote, clenching his buttocks suspiciously. So they did.
Ooh.
Was they used that as probable cause to get a search warrant to do a cavity search, and took this dude to a hospital. And the doctors there, when informed that they needed to do a cavity search on this dude because he was clenching his butt, the doctors told the cops to fuck off. Which they did.
Indeed.
And they went to another town in another county in another hospital, and where the doctors were more pliable. And the doctors there performed not one, not two, but three cavity searches in this dude. Found nothing, and then they put him under and did a colonoscopy on him, and again found nothing. Whereupon the gentleman was released. And now his lawyer is going to set the county on fire. As well he should.
I think so. Yeah, that sounds,
yes.
Pretty bad.
So, now that the police have entered that man's butt, we will now enter the cosmic butt, which is clearly a cosmic vagina, because that is clearly a cosmic cervix.
A cosmic butt-gina?
Absolutely not. Ugh, dude, how did this ever get into a video game? This is like Prey, dude. Oh, God. It's dilating. I'm not an Obi. Oh, what?
You are the son of the universe. Space baby.
Oh God, it's... What? Pokey, get out of
Aren't
my
you
mom's
dead?
Scooter. God, Pokey,
it's me.
Stop poking the cervix.
It's you.
A vagina, I am not.
That's pokey.
The apple of enlightenment has already made a prediction.
Ooh, call Apple Kid. He'll want to know about this.
We're deep inside the Apple Mom.
Pokey, I imagine, is a lot like Cartman.
Okay.
You know, I imagine him talking like that and acting like that.
Yeah, he's sort of a dick for his own dickish reasons. He doesn't really care about anybody else. Because of me. I was led by Giygas, and now I'm here.
It's all this guy.
Who's got two thumbs and gonna disrupt the plans of the universe? This guy. He said during an audio show where no one could see him doing the thumbs thing.
Oh, but it's okay. Giygas is no longer the wielder of evil.
Oh, great.
Yeah,
Wait. He is the evil power. Oh, crap. Okay, so...
Whoa. Pokey became a zombie at some point.
I'm concerned.
I like how, your head is an image on that... but it's still... It's at, like, a lower resolution than everything else.
This is, your head is only, like, 8 pixels across, in spite of this being, like, a giant 16-bit sprite.
Yeah. Also, nice Spider-Mobile, Pokey.
Yeah, looking pretty good, dude. I'm not sure who I should bomb first.
Did you get that at, Huffine's Spider-Mobile? Over on Beltline and 114.
Look, man, I don't have time for this. I'm gonna cast Freeze on this butthole. Rubsy, I think we should definitely use the defense shower. Get our D up. And I'm gonna punch Pokey in the face.
Just take a cold defense shower.
Do not, under any circumstances, become aroused inside the cosmic vagina.
You gotta keep yourself under control inside the cosmic vagina.
You don't wanna be the cosmic dad.
Just think about baseball.
Think of England. This music is tense. I'm gonna hit him. I'm going
this
all
is like way. Something. Like a hardcore band would make. This is something you would get on a The Locust album.
Hundred and 110 hit points, sounds good. Oh god, what the hell? Oh crap. Stop casting shit on me, I need to heal Rob. This is not going well.
And you're gonna have to take a second whack at this.
Yeah, probably.
You're gonna have to whack it off.
I would prefer not to. I'm not going fast enough. Go, go, go! Yes! Yes! No! You're a dick!
No, it's a vagina. We've already established that.
We're gonna die. Nope, that's not gone well. Wait, shh. I don't have anything funny to say about this, because this just sucks. Stop being a dick, Giygas.
Okay. What is Giygas doing, and what is Pokey doing?
They're attacking us. Giygas is using... Hang on. It is a gazillion years too early for you to oppose Giygas. You must feel pretty stupid to keep fighting without even knowing what Giygas looks like. If you were ever to see Giygas, you'd be so petrified of fear, you would never be able to run away. That's pretty scary, dude.
Yeah, turn it off!
Yeah, I don't like the devil's... Whoop. What?
I'm terrified, man.
Wait, what is this thing I'm looking at?
I'm trembling in my little booties. What's your angle, Pokey? What are you trying to accomplish here?
This game is... Is this list wider than it usually is?
I thought the same thing. Try Prey.
It looks...
Have you always had Prey on that list?
Naomi can always Prey. It's like her special move.
But now it's like in a column of its own.
Yeah, I feel like...
And look, it's like closer to goods than... It's oddly spaced.
Yeah, this is weird.
Right.
Right, I guess. Crap. We don't have any way to revive our other guys. We're gonna lose. This is gonna suck. Hit him with the bazooka, I guess. Well...
Oh.
Alright, Naomi, so I guess it's pretty much up to you and your six hit points.
Keep praying. Just keep doing it.
I guess. Great, I guess.
Okay.
Does she have any
tactic? You don't have anything that can revive any of these other guys?
No, none of this stuff will work. I think Lars was holding the only item that could do it. Normally I use Rufio for that, but he got wasted in the first part of the fight. Well, great, as long as Naomi's getting some...
See, we're coming out ahead.
Yeah, I guess.
We're doing well at praying. If you pray, I mean, can't you get, like... Isn't there, like, a range of, benefits for doing that, like...
Hey! Oh my god!
See? That... Like, Prey has a range... Every so often, you get a good benefit for it.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Every, like, 10 or so times you do it. We haven't really been doing it very much, have we?
It's usually not very useful, because sometimes you'll just blind everyone in the party like a total asshole. I'm gonna hit everybody with a defense shower. And then we're gonna...
Hit him with your bat.
Hit him with the gonna drop a ball. Oh, crap.
Shoot him with your gun.
This jackass is out of points. Yeah, Rufio's just about up out of PP.
Do you have anything that restores PP left?
Might. I'll have to look. Ow. Yeah, take it. A little D for everybody. I guess I hit him with the big guns. That's what you do with the boss fight, right? You just use your heaviest attacks over and over again.
Uh, See, now the menu has gone back to regular size. Naomi's menu has.
You know what? You know what it is? When she was our only guy, she was also the first person in the list, which means she had the auto attack and the runaway buttons, which normally Lars only has. And so she also has... She's a fifth command, but also had the sixth and the seventh ones. That's why it looked weird.
Hmm.
Now, okay, that makes sense.
I guess it was just, we were just fortunate with Prey then. Yeah.
It's like Rufio has Mirror. And, like, if he were the only guy alive, he would also have...
Use Mirror!
Okay.
See what happens. Maybe it'll reflect back.
Oh, Rufio cannot turn into Giygas. Turns out.
That would have been pretty cool.
Yeah.
If suddenly you had to fight two of them. Use everybody's special attack. Maybe that's Akini's battle. It's all special attacks.
Psy film didn't work on him at all. So I guess Lars just gotta keep... I'm gonna hit him with the super bomb.
Okay, I can hit him with the bomb, or I can hit him with the super bomb. I can wear the boot, or I can wear the super boot.
Shut up.
Material science people, not marketing people.
That's accurate. Ugh, true form of Giygas' attack sucks.
His true form is real wavy.
Yeah. It's indistinct, and it's red. Oh, great.
Giygas in his true form is really into the wave filter in Photoshop.
this, I guess.
You want my advice?
Yes.
Repeatedly use your strongest attack.
I tried to use, Lars' the strongest attack, but it doesn't do anything. It had no effect.
Can you just hit him with a bat?
Oh! Hey, what's
Pokey.
Up?
Hey, I guess we did it right?
And here you stand, waiting to be burned up with all the rest of the garbage of the universe.
Hit him with your bat before he finishes his speech.
What trigger do I pull to be a renegade and kill this asshole before he's done talking? My heart is beating incredibly fast. I must be experiencing absolute terror. Oh, this is an Evangelion game. Do you want to scream for help here in the dark?
You're in the dimension where the Evangelion, like, got sucked inside the shadow of the angel, and it went into another dimension, and pretty soon you're gonna, like, pop out of Giygas material form, and blood's gonna go everywhere, and you're gonna become a monster. You are the monster. You are the Giygas.
He wants me to call out. He wants me to call my. Whoa.
Okay. Pray.
I guess.
No, don't pray. Use your strongest attack. Pray. We don't. Yeah. Attack hard, fast.
They're gonna burn him.
Burn him with your fire.
I'm gonna shoot him with this bazooka, which seems like it should probably get the job done against the cosmic cervix. Congratulations, Rufio. You are now officially worthless.
Give him a cosmic vasectomy.
Awesome. That didn't help at all.
Friends, you cannot grasp the true form.
At least it didn't work.
That's pretty cool. A pretty cool looking attack.
Yeah.
Oh, Giygas! Why do you have to have such a complicated battle strategy?
What is this thing?
With you. Giygas.
I guess.
They're wavy.
I'm gonna keep hitting
it.
There's
two of them and... You know, it...
Didn't work, did it?
Where are you even? Like, where is this... On what surface is this battle taking place?
We had to go back in time to fight Giygas, so we went like millions of years into the past or something.
So are we floating in a point in space before the Earth was even created?
I guess. We went in some kind of cosmic orifice, and now we're here. Maybe he's a baby or something. Please give us strength, if it is possible, please. Somebody help us. What?
Yeah, what was all that?
I think I prayed.
Did all that happen automatically? Did you do any of that?
I prayed with Naomi. I need to get more PP so I can fight more. Well, later, Mr. Saturn.
Wait, did praying, like call these dudes, or did this happen automatically?
I prayed, and then this happened. That's all I know. All of the Mr. Saturns felt a new, startling feeling they had never experienced before. And they all started praying for the safety of Lars and his friends.
Well, I mean, wait a minute. Is this a scripted event, or is this something that happens, like, one of the possible effects of praying?
This has never happened with pray before. Giygas got
pray.
Weird.
Keep praying.
I guess. I'm gonna keep shooting this bazooka at him until
pray
such
your
time
little
as
heart
it
out.
Untenable.
And then Giygas will become the prey. The most dangerous game.
Please give us strength, anyone. Ugh, we're gonna have to watch one of these for every single one of these, aren't we?
Well, you think there's gonna be one? You think there's gonna be one for Moonside?
And we're gonna not.
We're gonna get help from a bunch of floating paintings. And
oh, hey, it's the Runaway Five.
Oh, hey, the Runaway Five.
You guys remember all that money I gave you? Can I have some of that back?
Do any of you guys have PP? I'm so sad. Lars.
Ow, dick. This dude's attacks suck.
They're not that bad. I mean, you're not like...
Yeah, it's really no big deal.
Chafing against the grain here, you know, you still got over 100 life, and you're not racing to...
We gotta unfreeze Rufio next turn. Ugh, grr. Oh. I'm...
Is Giygas saying that?
I guess. Additional praying is required.
Why don't you ever do things from the top of your heart?
Then you'd just be getting like a wafer-thin slice at the shitty part. I don't know.
Who's that?
Some
I don't remember that guy. Where was this Polestar place?
That's where you go to find Naomi at first, and she's missing. Oh, it's Naomi's dad.
Oh, I don't remember any of this. Naomi has a family?
I mean, she's just
like an orphan that we picked up somewhere along the way.
Oh, whole 90 hit points of damage. Great. Okay, so
did you just get all your HP back
after
that event?
I cast a spell with Lars to give everybody health a minute ago, right before that. Nope, this is all useless. Just keep hitting him with that, because I hit him with the good stuff. I want to save some... No. We need to
I feel like you should be using all special attacks. Like, that's gonna be the key here.
That seems likely. It hurts. It hurts. I couldn't grasp the true form of his attack, but I know that it did nothing.
We're getting ready to learn about the magic of friendship, Baxter.
Awesome.
It's gonna defeat Giygas.
A true, true friend helps a friend defeat Giygas.
We're gonna shoot a rainbow out, and Giygas is gonna melt.
Oh, it's all these are the kids from, Rob Z's school.
Was Rob Z was an orphan.
Kind of. He had a father, but his father, like, abandoned him at the orphanarium.
I think that constitutes being an orphan. I don't think your parents have to be dead. They just have to not
be parent
in possession
you.
Of you. Yeah.
And he prayed strongly for the safety of Rob Z and his friends.
Rob Z and anyone within a 5-meter radius.
Everybody cluster up so we get all the good parts of the prayers. My god, Rufio is still blinded and effed up? What the hell is going on over there, dude?
Nope. He's just taking the brunt of it.
Taking all the shots.
I wonder if Rufio's, like, chaps are gonna pray for us.
I hope so.
Are they gonna pray for us in some, like, devil language? From...
Go back.
Some eastern land. Whoa. Of... Lars!
Hey, Lars, hey, listen, Lars, listen, hey, man, check it out. Check out this lightning. This lightning is sick. Oh, it's the foreigners. Sounds good, man. So they started praying, right? Is that... okay.
Either praying or rattling change around in their pockets. One of the two.
They're doing something. That's all I can be sure of. I feel like we should save Lars's PP for healing in case he hits us real hard or something.
No, use special attack.
Fine. Give him the berries. Review, just keep punching Giygas, I guess.
Maybe if you, with Rufio, if you just keep using Mirror, maybe eventually you'll be able to become Giygas.
Ugh. I feel like that would make things way worse. Oh god, I don't want this jagoff prank. What is he doing to that little girl? Dude. Frank. Dude.
His method of praying involves a sacrifice, and...
he's praying diligent, and that little girl is like, oh god. Mister, please. Okay, the praying is now doing a tremendous amount of damage to Giygas.
Like, across time and space, it's doing all this damage.
Hey.
We can't grasp the true form of his attack, but we can count the effects in, like, units. I mean, how much better can you perceive something than to be able to... counted in units.
Yeah, like, count its exact effects. It hurts. I don't care.
Go back.
I like hurting you. You're the bad guy.
Okay, I'll go back.
You're made of gross, wavy stuff.
Show me the door, Giygas.
I don't want to leave through the cervix.
Okay, oh. How many groups of people are going to pray for us?
We've already gotten back to Lars's, like, mom, so... I guess we're probably
getting
close.
We're going to see our dad? We're going to finally see our dad?
No, our dad's at work. He's got shit to do, man. This is like that thing in Dragon Ball Z where Goku had to get spirit bomb juice from everything in the universe.
Yeah, it's in some ways like that.
It's taking about as long, too. Everybody stand in the air and shout for 22 and a half minutes. Oh. Oh, God.
I think I might have mentioned this to you before, but may not have mentioned it to our audience. Have you ever seen Dragon Ball Kai?
I have not.
It's Dragon Ball Z in like an extremely edited form, where they just edit out all the screaming and nonsense.
Why would anyone want to watch that? That's like
it's
80% of what's fun about friggin'.
No, dude, it's way better. It's awesome. Like Dragon Ball Digest.
Whoa. Naomi's call was absorbed by the darkness. That doesn't sound good.
The darkness is gonna pray for us, too.
Do I keep praying? Or should I just start doing attacks?
No, keep praying.
I'll keep shooting this bazooka at Giygas. Rob Z is the only practical man in this whole situation.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, whether you continuing to pray will do any benefit or not, I don't think Naomi is going to do much for
our cause here.
Hit this dude with blunt objects.
Yeah, hit Giygas with that frying pan. That'll probably get the job done.
I guess a bullet really doesn't count as a blunt object, because it's, you know, conical and everything.
Wait, what?
Beat the heart of...
Naomi and her friends call... Oh, God, what did we name ourselves?
Wait! You know, I don't think we typed that in.
Wait. Oh, God.
Is the file corrupted or something?
No. B. Gordon Barbasol, hear my prayer. B. Gordon Barbasol was on his knees in the temple.
Giygas now looks like one of those magic eye things where you can stare at it the right way, an object comes out. I'm trying to do it.
Is that a fetus? Is that what Giygas is right now?
You're a fetus.
Thanks, bro.
A D-fetus?
Oh. It's gonna seem like I'm running away.
You may think that I'm running away. Do not be deceived.
When we get back home and win it, we're gonna go to Pookie's house and cave his goddamn face in with a baseball bat.
By all ostensible appearances, I will be running away. But in fact...
Yo, man, I'm trying to jump in the spider car. Peace out, man. I'll catch up with you. Pokemon, it didn't look like you were running away. It looks like you just disappeared.
Later, Pokey. Whatever, man.
When you go, leave the LSD. Oh.
What is that white noise? Like, what would be... Where are we that there would be white noise?
Aren't we in robots right now? Maybe this is the robot connection being disrupted.
Oh. But, like, what would be interfering with our signal?
Millions of years of space-time? I don't know.
I guess there's radiation everywhere. You know, it can pretty much be anything.
We forgot to pay our cable bill.
Yeah. Okay. Game over. Nice job.
Wait.
Okay, game over.
Did you see her spaz out for a second? Oh. We have been ejected from the cosmic vagina.
Gross.
The war is over. Pookie was always a red herring, man. A fat red herring. So... Hey, you give me that goddamn dot back. Oh!
Baxter.
Shh. This is important.
The search is over. You were with me all the while.
And you, Scarecrow, you just needed a gun.
Fade to white. This is our funeral.
Oh, here comes our hooju. Did Rufio just get the Allspark? The Matrix of Leadership?
Are you guys seeing this? Like, what is this wall of light and...
Does anyone want to call, like, some EMTs or something, or maybe a doctor? A real doctor, though. Okay, sweet. Sounds good. I hope it just gives me control again. Uh-oh.
Oh, do they have to end here? Can I at least go back to my house? I mean...
Do you guys want to go get a beer or something? We have beaten a lot of animals to death together.
You want to come over and, like, I don't know, play some Earthbound or something?
I'll get out my Fairchild Channel F. We'll have a good time. Let me demonstrate a strange power before I go. Okay, come on. Put your pants back on, dude. Sigh, farewell. Okay.
It was a pretty quick goodbye for... We just had this whole epic journey to get... Well, not Rufio. He's kind of a punk.
He's dropping hot science on us. Whoa. Rob, get up. Get up off my lid. Whoa.
Rob, I'll tell you straight. I'm kinda into this.
I feel like I should probably be killing way more animals. Some of the theories that I have been studying so hard. It's remarkable. Yeah, it was really cool when you made that bazooka and then shot a space baby to death with it. I was into that.
It's remarkable. You can tell by the fact that I'm remarking on it. Why would we get hitched? Has that even been, like, a subplot or anything?
You're a subplot.
Yeah, kinda. I'm like a background character on this show.
Nobody's a foreground character except this ridiculous game. Somebody better high-five somebody here in a second or I'm gonna freak out.
Not one of the Moon Men, because I don't have hands. I mean, the Saturn Men.
If I just say no, will she just leave?
Try it.
I feel like
don't
I
do
shouldn't.
It. Escort her home.
Oh god, everything is so
slow. Yeah! Walking her home.
Steve, making copies. A letter from Tony.
The Steve Meister! Steve-o-rama! Making copies!
Playing ridiculous Super Nintendo games.
Read the letter from Tony.
Dear Naomi, how are you doing? I hope the letter from Tony is like, yo, Rob, you owe me money! I'm gonna get my $2!
I find too, so are me.
Me also. Me okay. What? Please come and play with us again at the Polestar Preschool. Bring us some presents. Yay.
Okay. I can manage that.
A letter from Tony. Everything's going really great. I wish I could have gone with you on your adventure. But instead...
Here, we got all this interesting stuff on our journey, kids. Check it out. I got this sick frying pan.
I killed a guy with a bat. Like, a lot.
I got this gun.
And I got this secret herb.
Yeah.
Shh, don't tell your parents. This kid's waiting to clean his glasses. Creepy codependent shit going on here. Finally, the letter from mom.
These letters.
Since you left home on your journey, things have changed. There's less laundry. We don't use much capital S steak. I heard that you defeated a universal evil. Googie. Did we name Tracy? Or is her name always Tracy?
I don't think we named Tracy. I don't think we would have chosen the name Tracy.
That seems likely.
You know? You know what's funny? When we started this game, I thought Rob Z was gonna be the stupidest thing, and we were never gonna get used to it. I've totally gotten used to it now, and I would not think of that character as anything but Rob Z.
Yeah, I find it really annoying that they have, like, canon names, and so when you go to, like, read the wiki about this game, it's like, and then Jeff does this, I'm like, who the hell is Jeff?
Which one is Jeff?
Jeff is Rob Z.
What's Naomi's real name?
Paula, I think.
What's, I know, Lara's real name is Ness.
Yeah.
What's, Rufio's real name?
Pooh. Yep.
Well, yeah. We made good choices.
We also named our dog Carl.
See how far that went.
Oh, I guess we gotta take her back to the,
Yeah, you gotta take Naomi home.
No, we're going back to my place, girl. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. She's
still... take her back to her place. See her bedroom.
Bow, 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 bow. We're taking her back to a preschool, which makes me uncomfortable.
Pink sheets.
Ugh. They're gonna be pinker when we're done with them. What?
Ugh.
Yeah. I'm gonna save our game. Oh, hey! Jackass.
Wait, what did he say?
He's like, I always see you walking around. Walking is good for your health.
Go around, talk to assholes. See if they say anything.
See if they show some respect.
Different. Now that the game is over. Yeah,
the town
it's all different.
Is more peaceful and safe.
Just walk around and talk to some chaps. See what goes on.
What's up, kid? Yes, I am a Runaway 5 groupie.
That doesn't sound like
this dog looks perturbed.
At least there are no enemies anymore.
Amen. Yeah.
None of this is new.
Oh man, let's go visit Orange Kid, because that guy was useless. Yo, what's up?
Huh.
Yep. Orange Kid just needs a little bit more for his grip, so he can finish his great invention. F it.
He used up all his grant money.
Oh, good. Bye.
So long. Adios. Hasta la vista.
I'm not leaving here without a kiss, Naomi. I don't know what you kind of man you think I am.
I'm not saying it has to be from you. I'm just saying.
Somebody's kissing. Hey, what's up?
That cat has one color of head and a different color of body.
Yes.
What's up with that?
Fine.
Well, yep. Well, fuck you too.
Whatever, lady.
Mitch! You made me walk all the way back here and I don't even get... Not even like a little rub down?
Whoa! I need you to stop macking on the preschoolers. Man, there better be some cheese at the end of this maze.
Go see what the meteorite's still there.
Alright. Ooh, maybe Buzz will come back.
Get a piece of the meteorite for, you know, souvenir.
I like this game gave us a bicycle that turned out to be totally superfluous.
Yeah. Well, it might not have been total. It might have had applications that we never figured out because we put the thing in storage as soon as we got it.
You can't do anything with it if there's other people in your party. Ooh. On our way back, we gotta stop in and crack Pokey's skull a couple of times.
Really? Was that why we put it away? Because we couldn't ride it when there were other people in our party?
Yeah, you can't even ride it when you have a teddy bear in your team. So you can only use it when you're alone.
That's awful.
Yeah.
You're never alone. There's like assholes following you around constantly. You're like some kind of celebrity. But you haven't done anything. You're like a celebrity. It's like all the bad parts of being a celebrity and none of the, like, rolls of fat cash. Well, there it is.
Yep.
Still there, still glowing.
Still.
After, like, days and days of sitting in the earth.
Throbbing with the terrible heat of a million suns.
Okay.
Woo! Day no maw.
Conclude this. Negative. Get to the screen that says game, the end. Get to that screen.
Okay. But first, Pokey's house.
He's gonna walk in and stab him in his sleep.
Just grab Picky and drag him out of the house.
Oh, crap. Drip acid into his ear.
I just want to completely fill his body with spiders. Hey, what's up, Picky?
Replace his blood with spiders.
Well, that was awesome.
Make him drink a milkshake made of spiders.
This is Mr. Prettyman. How you doing, Prettyman? Yes, I am the boy next door. Please put your camcorder away, you're freaking me out.
Wait, so did we reset history?
I don't know.
Because he hated us before.
That's Mr. Prettyman, that's not Mr. Mitch.
Oh.
Remember, we had to beat up Mr. Mitch or something, because we met him in Foreside. Let's call our dad. Hey, what's up, Pops?
Mock pizza? Man, we did so many things in this game, I don't remember any of them.
I don't remember ever ordering pizza.
Order a pizza.
Excuse me, good heavens.
I want to see our dad.
Not gonna
I think
happen.
Our dad needs to order a pizza.
What's up, Carl?
Order a pizza now, and by the time you finish the game, it'll probably get here.
Our delivery men got tired and quit. Thank you for never calling us and ordering a pizza.
They should have had the mock pizza tracker.
Awesome.
It would have been a good value add to keep their business afloat.
Oh, God. The creeper bought a photo album by.
I want to see our photos.
I don't.
I want to see us giving the same dumb expression at like 1,000 different locations. York!
Tracy, please. I need you to stop. Please, no Yorking in the house.
Do we? I don't know.
Sure. I don't need any of this shit anymore, Tracy.
That's what she... I was gonna say that's what she said, but...
Turns out it was.
She didn't... Aww. It just isn't working out!
It says there's no problem. I feel... What else could there possibly be
painting.
To... No.
Inspect that painting. Inspect that painting.
No.
You think that's a painting, or you think that's like a needlepoint?
What the hell else does this game want from me? Is that the joke? Is the joke that the game never ends? I'm just trapped in this hell forever?
Why? I don't think so. I bet there's a the end screen.
Where's the guy?
Talk to the guy. Oh, wait, no, never mind. Go to the guy who is really into meteorites.
Oh, yeah. I forget his name. Whoa!
Gosh, pedestrian zone, thank you.
In the meantime, why don't you go and look up what we're supposed to do? After we defeat Giygas.
I'm gonna look it up, but I'm not gonna just tell you. I'm gonna give you gradual hints.
Oh, God. This episode's gonna be 3 hours long.
Okay. Let's see, Earth. Let's go to Game FAQs. That's a good... They have...
We named ourselves B. Gordon Barbasol. And in the end, we cried out to ourselves.
Earthbound. Where do you just get, walkthroughs?
Game Facts.
I'm on Game Facts. Oh, Facts and Guides page. There we go.
Yeah. What's up, man?
In-depth facts? Walkthrough. There we go. And...
I guess just skip to the end.
Epilogue is where we are, probably. Okay, epilogue. Giygas, Universal Destroyer. When you arrive at Saturn Valley, you will find that the Phase Distorter 2 is almost finished, but some fat piggy kid came and kidnapped Mr. Saturn. Yada yada yada. Oh! That was it. We were just supposed to pray.
Is that the whole thing?
Yeah, pray was the, we just kind of stumbled right into that, didn't we?
No, we did not. I just knew that.
You knew that?
Yeah. I read that years ago when we first started this, but I wanted to keep it a secret to keep up the tension. I didn't want to just be like that.
Well, but now you've admitted it to our whole audience and to me, and I think less of you because of it.
That's okay, because I hate you. What are we supposed to do now? What do we do? What do we do? What
Bring
do we do?
Her.
What do we do?
Keep praying as long as Paula is alive.
Keep hitting page down until you get to something after this.
Is there anyone else to call? That's where it ends.
It just stops? What the hell am I supposed to do now?
Well, hold on. Let me go to a different walkthrough.
Maybe we have to go to sleep. Let's go to the hotel. You know, the hourly hotel.
Can you sleep in your room?
No, I tried.
Game script, maybe? Okay, that's game script.
Where the hell is the hotel in this town?
Damn. Okay, let's try this one.
We are more confused by the part of this game that has no gameplay at all than we are by all the other parts combined. The hotel.
Glitches, codes.
Wanted police chief finishes Earthbound, asks, quote, where is the sequel, unquote.
This is ridiculous. I don't know what to do.
Maybe that's
and
the joke.
All the gut. That's not gonna be it, man. It would not just do that to you. Okay, here's the Giygas boss fight.
Oh, we just have to talk to our mom again. Yes, I'm done.
These earthly congratulations, you have finally beaten Earthbound. Now you can have some in-game fun. The spirits of the party return to their earthly bodies. Jeff and Pooh say goodbye to everyone, and Paula asks you to take her home. You can travel the world here and see how things have changed. However, to truly finish the game and see the credits, return Paula to her home in Tucson. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Are you watching it?
Yep.
Switch back to it. Oh.
Lard the bitch.
Well, damn it, I was reading the thing. I didn't get to see it. What happened?
I mean, this is happening, man. Just get over here.
I'm watching the credits now, but, like, what happened when you talk to your mom?
She's just like, you can share all your experiences with me. BH Purple.
That's pretty lackluster.
Remember, we had to fight all the cops.
Remember the land sharks or whatever?
Yeah. In the arcade, the kid like runs up to you and says like, "What?" And I was like, "What's the matter with you?"
Let's reminisce about the good times we've had in Earthbound.
Good old Runaway 5.
And now let's end that activity because I remember those assholes where they were all over that room.
Yeah. We formed a maze because we're sons of bitches. Oh god. I hope, Oh, it's Tessie.
Oh, baby.
Man, remember Tessie? The first time we saw Tessie rise up out of the ocean?
I'd say that's probably the funniest...
Oh god, it's ass mouth.
Funniest moment. Yeah. I like that, how it actually used our names in the final credits.
Yeah. It'll suddenly display a picture of us, and it says B. Gordon Barbasol underneath.
What's the backhoe's name?
B. Gordon Barbasol.
Gerardo Montague. Two houses. How does it go?
A pox on both your houses?
Sure.
Okay. It's Rufio. And his unnamed
Rufio's
master.
Rufio's Star Master.
Oh, God.
Dungeon Man. I am Dungeon Man!
Oh god, it's the Tendas.
Observe my ridiculous dance. Remember those guys who did nothing for us?
They helped us out, and they were just brutally murdered in exchange.
Yeah, we slaughtered probably 5 or 6 of them before we figured out what we were even doing. Look at all these clowns. Real cornucopia. Types here. That's good.
That's
I like
fantastic.
That. To what, Lars?
He's flipping you the double deuce, but he can't be bothered to have two hands up. Oh, God. No, not in a dark room like this. Like this. Oh, he's leaving. No!
Oh, great. Now we have to watch this new slideshow.
Mr. Barbasol, please uncover your face. Oh, he took a photo of us.
The player.
Oh, it's the real credits now.
I bet it's gonna show our whole album. Except, this is all... That dude was standing right next to us when he took each one of those pictures, and these pictures are obviously taken from a different vantage point.
It's all shooped. Actually, it was all Lakitu actually taking the pictures. You know, that cloud dude with the fishing pole from Mario. You think you don't know what I'm talking about, but you know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
I just elected not to respond.
Because it was dumb.
No.
Okay.
Just because I'm an ass.
Yeah, that's true. Man, we finished this game.
Thank God, right? We can move on to bigger and better things.
Now I can finally hurl myself off the roof.
Font designers! Now, I'm gonna learn you guys a thing or two about readable fonts.
Let's talk for a minute about the Saturns, you bastards.
Let's talk about, the attacks with a gamma on the, in the name. That symbol, I mean, it took me forever to figure out what that symbol was.
It's a cursive J, don't be an idiot.
I do rather like the font, the purple, font in these credits, though. Yeah. I kind of want that font.
Frankly, you could probably take a couple of screenshots of this and have it covered.
Yeah, probably could.
That X looks weird.
I want to take out the outline, though. Just have the inner,
the inner light purple. Purple
part. Yeah. The inner purple, there's our album name. No, that's today's episode, okay?
The inner purple.
The inner purple.
I'm writing that down.
Mapper Kojima.
That's weird. Maybe that's
Shige maybe that's Shatsu, the name of a company okay? Itoi.
Maybe there's a bunch of jokes in these credits and we've just not been paying attention.
Think M.D. Seeger is related to Bob Seeger. It's like Bob Seeger's cousin. It's like, yeah, I can play guitar.
Yes, I choose to believe that.
Ritsuo Kamimura. So this game was developed by a bunch of ninjas?
Yes.
What's going on here?
I like how everybody else is just standing there deadpan in all these photos. Lars is the only one posing.
And many others. Oh, it's Shell Art Vision.
Yeah, he's my favorite Art Vision. Dr. Art Vision, they call him.
Lucky Nice.
On Associates.
What? One of these names is not like the other.
Who let the white guy in here? Yeah. Marcus, get out of the goddamn... Oh god, it's Mike. Oh, hey! Shigeru Miyamoto. Finally, a name with some cachet.
Who is this Nintendo? Oh, Ape Incorporated.
Awesome.
Where the business ape works.
No, he works at Ape LLC. He's a limited liability primate. I'm an idiot. F2.
I feel like if we were, like, a little more invested in what was going on, we'd be real disappointed that we named ourselves such a stupid thing. You know? Like, we got through this whole game and then watched, and it's all sort of nostalgic and... But...
I could see being super excited by this game if I were a kid.
I could see being super excited about this game if the last, you know, 15 years had not occurred. You know?
Yeah. If it were 1994, this game would be awesome.
Yeah.
Oh. We should end the episode here.
God, we're not going to make another Earthbound episode.
We totally are.
We're not going to make
another Earthbound. This is happening. You can't stop me.
Is our next episode going to be like, a minute long?
Yes. It's going to be awesome.
Okay. We'll do it. End it. But let's keep recording. And just make it now.
No, why are you ruining my life?
I'm just being good at time management.
Time management is for exclusively the purview of, I don't know, undesirable minority.
You know, we already probably need to make this 2 episodes.
Oh,
we've already been playing for 1 hour and 20 minutes.
Oh, God. No.
Say yes.
It just turns off.
Yeah, that's how we end it, right? This is like the... There is no more story. You can just wander around the world.
I feel like the game may have just started over and we've just rolled into New Game
Plus.
Are
we in, like, new... Is it New Game Plus? Is there more game?
Oh god, it's picky.
No, we just started over, dude. This is the first...
Oh wait, he got a letter.
Wait.
He says, come and get me, loser.
Oh shit.
Spankity, spankity, spankity.
He wrote that? he actually wrote out spankity, spankity?
There it is. There it
ellipsis?
Is.
Question mark! What is it? Hello?
Look, man.
Are you asking me?
Ladies and gentlemen of the supposed jury, this has been episode 44 of A Tall Cold Glass of Giygas.
Are you sure it's not 45?
I'm pretty sure it's 44.
44 episodes, man. But I don't know about that question mark. I mean, do we need to... Is there more game or what?
I'm hitting the L button.
Is there a true ending of sorts?
We will never find out. I'm hitting all the buttons, nothing's happening. This game is over. Thank goodness I saved.
Well.
And then it just turned off. Well, there you have it.
Wait, you mean the game turned off?
Yeah,
it's recording, right?
No, the recording's probably fine. It just dumped me back to Z-SNES. So I guess we'll catch you people later. See you next time.
Do we know what we're going to play next time?
Nope. We'll figure
we'll
something out.
We'll have to make a decision. Well, let's play a game that's less...
Terrible?
Less involved. Oh. No, this game was good. I mean, overall, we could have made a worse choice. We could have played SWAT Cats.
Oh, God. Yeah, you're right.
We almost did play SWAT Cats.
Yeah.
We were on the precipice of playing SWAT Cats.
We'll hold forth about that at great length next time.
I think we held forth about that on episode 1.
Probably.
And gave the whole story of the genesis of our attempt to copy Endurance Run because we didn't have enough Endurance Run.
Yeah. Well, anyway.
I don't know, how did you feel about it?
This whole thing?
Yeah, how did you feel about the process of learning how to make one of these Let's Play sorts of videos where we play through an entire game and comment on it? Are we funny?
No.
Oh.
But we'll talk about that more next time.
Will we?
I don't know, probably.
You think we're better at it than we were in episode 1?
Considerably. But seriously, I'm concerned about the state of my SSD being completely filled with footage.
We're ending. It's over.
We're leaving.
It already ended.
What we're saying now is not even going to be on the tape. Shut it down. No, this is all on tape. It's all.